I would like to first to thank AgroStack organization for allowing me to present my work. I'm Céline Baron. I'm statistician in Diana Pet Food Research for 13 years. And today I will present you the development of a new method to assess dog food satiety performance. So, as Julien just explained before, Diana Pet Food aims at answering the need of three different users: the pet, the pet owner, and the pet manufacturer. Diana Pet Food provides multiple products and services improving pet food palatability, pet health, and food protection. And we are also very lucky to have Panelis, an expert measurement center, which provides insight into pet preference and behaviors. I will quickly show you what it looks like if it works. No, it doesn't work. So I can show you the video for the next time. Sorry. Like for human dogs, overweight and obesity for dogs issue have increasing during the last decades. This leads for dogs health problem like arthritis, heart disease, diabetes, breathing problems, skin problem. To fight overweight, the strategy of pet food manufacturer is to add satiating ingredient to the diets like fiber. But as you can must know, dogs can talk, so it's very difficult to measure pet food satiety efficacy. Currently, the clinical study to measure weight management on overweight dog have a duration of at least 3 months. Here, the objective of this study is to develop a method to evaluate quickly the level of satiety induced by different dog foods. We want to use Panelis to measure it, so we have some constraints. This method should be reliable in short term, non-invasive. And we want to control the food and the environment of dogs. So we have two hypotheses. The first one was that hormonal signal related to satiety act within 14 minutes after ingestion. And the second was that the exposition to satiating diet should rapidly lead to a reduction in consumption. So we think about protocol. We want to feed dogs during 2 days with satiating diets. That is to say 4 meals. And after the last meal, the fourth meal, we will present a classical diet 40 minutes after the last meal, which is called a challenge test. We expect that the food consumption during the challenge test should decrease for dogs previously fed with satiating diets. In the protocol, we test 4 different diets. So we have 2 doses of protein hydrolysates. That's our nutrition brands develops, and which have show effectiveness in satiety in murines in a PhD thesis. We also have a third product it's a control product, that it's the same, exactly the same diet without hydrolysate in inclusion. And the fourth product was a benchmark. It's a commercial weight management diet. We chose it because in a previous in-home study, it shows a decrease in consumption during the 5 days of the study. We chose also a super premium commercial dog diet for challenge to be attractive. And between period of testing, we choose another diet as washout diet. The population is 38 dogs, lower than 15 kilos. We allocated in four groups and randomized in Latin Square to avoid the order effect. And the total duration of the study was 2 weeks. This is an example of food presentation for the first group. So as you can see on the Monday and Thursday, this is the first day of food presentation. On the Tuesday and Friday, the second day, and at the end of the second day, we have the challenge test 40 minutes after the last meal. The Wednesday and the Sunday and Saturday was used as washout between periods. Before beginning the study, we perform a palatability test to avoid the misinterpretation of the results because we don't have any idea of the palatability of the food testing. So we use for that a complete pairwise design, and we calculate Bradley-Terry score on consumption. We have two main analyses. The first one is the consumption divided by the metabolic weight of the challenge test. So we use the consumption divided by the metabolic weight to minimize the effect of different breed size and weight of dogs. For this primary variable, we use a mixed model with dog as random effect, the previous diet as categorical effect, and into the model, we have also the consumption of the previous meal. For the second analysis was the consumption of the 2 days prior challenge test. The same, we use also a mixed model with the dog as random effect and the effect of diet day and day by and diet by day interaction. For the results, prior the study, we did the palatability test. And as you can see, the two diet with hydrolysate had better palatability than the control and the benchmark. Here we have the results of the 2 days before the challenge test. So we have a day effect. So whatever the diet, consumption on the day two is lower, and that it's due to the novelty effect. So we can see that very commonly in panelists. We also have a day effect. Despite a higher palatability, the diets with hydrolysate are less consumed than the controls. So we can say that there is a satiating effect in the 2 days before the challenge test. We can see also that benchmark it's the less consumed, but it's also less palatable. So we have two possible conclusions. That may be a satiating effect, or that may be a palatability effect. The second analysis was the consumption of the challenge test. So here we have, I forget to say that the population of this analysis is only dogs that consumed 35% of the last meal before the challenge test in order to have the effect of satiating ingredient. So the result is that we have a previous diet effect. We can say that the consumption level of the challenge test for dog fed with hydrolysate are lower than the control. So the challenge test here confirms the hydrolysate satiating effect. In the other hand, we have a consumption level of the benchmark, the consumption level of dogs previously fed with benchmark is highest than the other product. So we can say that there is no satiating effect for the benchmark, and the less consumption of the 2 days before was due must due to lower palatability and not due to satiety. So we can say that the new method allow distinguish satiety effect from low palatability behind decreased consumption. And to conclude, we can say that adding protein hydrolysate in the diet significantly increased dog satiety. We can say also that the newly method allow a reliable measurement of dog for short-term satiating efficacy. This evaluation gives the first level of information to pet food manufacturer to be confirmed with clinical study on overweight dogs. Results could be completed with phylogenetic study, including follow-up of satiety hormone release. And to finish, I can say that the analysis of kinetics of consumption could help also to understand the mechanism of action of satiating ingredients. So thank you for attention.
Thank you, Céline, for this talk. Okay. Do you have any, maybe you can share, stop sharing, please?
Yes.
Thank you. And it's time for question. If you have so, yes, Pascal. You're in mute.
Thank you. Thank you, Céline, for this fascinating talk. It's always complicated, much more complicated pet food than human food studies. Huh?
Yes, and, you're right.
Yeah, I've been involved in that long time ago, and wow. And I'm not sure I understood. Did you put the palatability score as a covariate in your models or not?
No.
Maybe.
It was just, we can test it, but it was just to avoid a misinterpretation of the result.
But then,
in fact,
you can adjust for
yes,
and this is what we are interested in, I believe.
Yes, it's a good idea.
Yeah. And possibly also, but it depends if it's the same dog who did the palatability test and the society test. But then if you have individual scores for palatability, that would be even better as a covariate.
Yes, it was not the same.
It was, but they were not the same. Yeah. Yes. Mm-hmm. Okay. 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 And also, I was surprised because you defined society as 40 minutes after the last meal. And are you sure you're not talking about association instead of society? You see what I mean?
Yes. Yes.
The dog.
Yes, maybe.
The dogs are able to eat every 40 minutes. Yes.
Yes.
A full meal. dog,
yes. In fact, I don't talk about it, but we test a lot of. We test 20 minutes, 40 minutes, and 30 minutes. And in the 20 and 40 minutes, we can see the satiating effect, but 60 minutes, we can see that it's only linked to the amount of last meal.
Okay, cool. Thank you. Thank you, Céline.
You're welcome.
We've got another question in the chat from Lucille Karadek.
As the behavior of the dog significantly change under the different diets, such as water consumption? No. No, but I think it would be interesting to, because we have this co-development of hydrolysate in our society, and I think it would be very interesting to test it in a clinical study to see if there is an effect on other wild dog, because in Panelis it's healthy dog, so the behavior not change.
Okay. I've got one question. Did you test the removing pair effect that Julien just presented before?
No, because Julien didn't finish his work.
He didn't share
at this moment. Yes. The timing was not
okay.
Okay. For the next time.